Greetings and welcome to this new Mekanika video. I'm Quentin and I'm thrilled to introduce our brand new laser head today. So let's dive in right away with the presentation of the main components of the kit. First and foremost, the kit includes a magnetic docking station which provides a smooth connection for quick and efficient setup. It also ensures a secure attachment that is always perfectly aligned with the machine tool head. If your project only requires CNC milling, you can simply remove the laser head and protect the electronics from dust with this aluminium cap. The adapter is the controlling unit of the laser. It serves as a safety interface that indicates its operating mode with three LEDs. Use the key to turn the power on and the first indicator will light up. Now to start using the laser, you need to press the red button once. You will hear the fan of the laser turning on, meaning that it is armed and ready to receive instructions. You can simply press that button again whenever you need to stop the laser. Let's switch to Planet CNC now to see how we can send instructions to the laser. As you can see, two new buttons have been added to the left sidebar. The first button is very important as it swaps the current tool with the laser head. After being notified by a pop-up window, you will see in the info panel that the tool number has changed to a number between 90 and 93, depending on your machine model. These numbers are reserved for the laser and should not be used in your CAM to define an end mill. When you press the button, you will also notice that the machine moves the laser head to the last XY working coordinate of the spindle. This allows you to keep the exact same reference from a part that you were milling before. No need to redefine the 0XY coordinates. Now that the laser tool is selected, pressing the spindle icon will power the laser instead of the spindle. The second button is very similar to the standard tool measure length button. As for any other tool, attach the crocodile clip to the laser and press the button. When it touches the probe base, it will automatically move to the correct focal distance and set it to Z0. You can also, of course, do it manually with the aluminum gauge and jog to the correct focal length. Then you can set it to Z0. Now a word about safety. When working with laser technology, it's crucial to follow some safety guidelines. Ensure you're always wearing protective glasses and always operate the modular laser head in a well-ventilated space. Bear in mind that not all materials can be laser cut safely and always do research on that topic before trying. PVC is a good example of this issue as it produces very hazardous chloride fumes when being laser cut or engraved. So as always, if you notice a problem, you can press the emergency stop button, which will stop the laser and the machine movement immediately. And finally, if you have children or inexperienced people around, don't leave the keys on the adapter to prevent them from turning on the laser by mistake. That's it for this quick presentation of our laser head. If you have any questions or thoughts, feel free to drop them in the comments below. And if you want to know more about how to create a G-code to use your laser, you can check our other tutorial on Lightbulb. So please like and share and subscribe for more exciting updates from Mekanika. And until next time, bye!